And we're very pleased, Miolina, back at the museum again. This is the third or fourth time. It's always a great program that they put on, so we're excited for that. So the theme of their show is about wood, because it's in conjunction with our current exhibition, which is wood, which explores the use of a new type of engineered wood product that's being used in skyscrapers around the world called mass timber. So I hope you got to look at the exhibition a little bit, and you can check it out a little bit more after the show during a little reception that we're going to be having after the show, okay? So on your programs, if you scan that QR code, you will see Miolina's website, and you can check out their social media there to see their other concerts and other programs at other museums. Tomorrow, there will also be a children's concert for families called Returning to Our Roots. So if you have any little friends that you'd like to bring tomorrow at 10:30 a.m., they'll be putting on another show tomorrow. And I think that's it for me. So now I'm going to welcome Miolina to the stage.
Which includes a technique on violin that is called colegno. And colegno is when you play with the wood of the bow. So that is very appropriate for the timber theme.
And then violin is made from wood.
So. Yes, we're very lucky that we're not trumpet players. Would like to do New York Sounds for you today because she gets a lot of musical sounds that sound like traffic horns and taxis and subways and people scurrying and hurrying. And she's able to do those kind of metallic sounds, but with wooden instruments. So we thought that was kind of an interesting, you know, piece. So hope you enjoy the New York sounds. Thank you. one is a composer who wrote this piece, really beautiful piece for us in 2017. His name is Sonny Knable, and he is based in Queens. And the piece is based on the works of Hokusai, the Japanese artist. So if you look at your QR codes on your programs, you can see the images affiliated with the pieces we'll be playing. So there are actually 10 of them, but we chose the ones which are just affiliated with things like wood. So if you go to your QR code, I will demonstrate. That'll take you to this page. It comes up. It worked upstairs. No, it's not working. There we go. Okay. So you have our program info, and you have like our bio. You have info on all of the composers if you're curious after the concert or during the concert. But there is a PDF. If you click on that PDF, you will get all 10 of the hokusai that each movement is based on. But we will be doing the first two. And if you kind of zoom in, you will see that it does have the numbers of the movements, but it's 1 and 2, and then you have to scroll down to 8 and 9, and those are the ones that have like really beautiful pictures of wood. So the first one they're building, the second one they're carrying the timber, the next one down here, it has pink flowers, it's a tea plantation, and the plantation is also made, you know, the buildings are made of wood, and then this one they're growing, I think, sort of in the water with oars. So those are the images affiliated.
So Hokusai was made pictures by wood. He was carving the wood, and then he put the colors on top of it. So the another aspect of wood.
Yeah, wood
block. And then you hear in this piece, we play with the Coreno Fatuto. We use the wood side of the bow and then bouncing on the string, so you hear more woody sound, or you know, tapping on the violin, so you hear wood sound here.
So, great. So lots of wood involved in this. So the first one is the Honjo Tate Timbre.
Number 2.
now we can scroll down to number 8, which is 3 from the bottom, if you're following the pictures.
Thank you.
in Sweden, and he wrote us a tango called El Solitario, and I won't read you the program notes about it because it actually relates to it. So he wrote about this piece. It's called The Loner in English, and the inspiration for the title came from a solitary pine tree in Holmen in the northern parts of Stockholm. So that was his inspiration for this piece. And you had a theory about
that. He lived in Sweden as an immigrant, so he described himself as pine tree living in Sweden, and tradition, carrying the tradition of tango music. That's my interpretation.
And this is from a whole, we have a whole program of all Scandinavian music that was called Maple, Birch, Wood, and Pine, based on some of the other pieces were also sort of tree-based. But they had electronics and stuff that were more complicated to do. And then also our instruments are made out of like screws and maple and things like that. So that's how the title of that program came up. And this piece was originally for that program.
Thank you. Vancouver, I composed the next piece. I wrote this as part of an artist residency with Miolina years ago up at Avalok, which is in New Hampshire. So I think that the main tie-in with the theme of the program is that a city kid, born and raised here in Manhattan, there in New Hampshire among all the trees and everything, composing as quickly as I could this 4-minute work, which Miolina has performed a number of times now. And it reflects a range of influences from jazz to rock music and modern classical. But Lynn already mentioned a little bit about the woods of the violin.
You can talk more.
Hold it up for a minute. You know which woods you're looking at here in particular? She mentioned two of them. The sides and the back of the violin are made from maple, which is a hardwood. And you might be thinking, well, there are other hardwoods like oak or walnut or ash. But no, they don't usually, they almost always, it's maple that's used for the back and sides of the violin and the neck of the instrument. The bridge also.
Mine is 1927.
The bridge is also maple. Kind of interesting, I think of these cables going on the bridge, right? The top of the instrument is not a hardwood. It's spruce. The softwood, not cedar or pine, right? Like, oh, there are other woods. Almost always they use spruce for the top and maple for the back and sides and neck of the instrument. The fittings can be boxwood or other things. The frog of the bow, for example, is ebony on Lynn's bow, just like the ebony that's used for the fingerboards. They need a really strong wood to withstand all the action that's from the fingers and strings and such, right? And then there's one more wood, we mentioned three of them, right? Maple, spruce, right, ebony, and what about the bow? Hold up the bow.
Pernambuco.
There you go. Pernambuco wood from Brazil. Sometimes, you know, the violinists, they talk, well, where's your instrument from? You know, that kind of thing. Oh, like Italian violin, and I have a French bow, you know, I bought it in Paris. And say, well, actually, that tree where the violin bow, where that stick of wood came from, is from Brazil. You say, oh, Brazil, Pernambuco. And it's that kind of combination, that recipe, where it's almost exclusively used with the violins, yeah. And interestingly, Lynn's violin, hold up for a minute, as you mentioned, 1927, right?
Yeah.
So I think that this, in a way, this concert is a testament to the power of these materials, the sound that we're hearing. Lynn's instrument was made by her teacher's grandfather.
No, my teacher's father.
Teacher's father, in Pittsburgh, almost 100 years ago. And while the instrument was made here in the States, Benjamin Phillips, the violin maker, he was known for sourcing the maple. In a sense, it's an example of recycling or repurposing, if you will, from buildings over in Europe. So the woods that are in Lynn's violin at one time were part of a structure of a building over in Europe, you know? So for centuries or whatever, this kind of strength in a way is reflected here. Anyway, I hope you enjoy Kit and Caboodle's just a 4-minute piece.
Her violin's older than
mine. I don't know the history. Okay. Tell us.
But my violin is made by Villon. It's French.
Ah, yes.
1860. Ooh. And then as a, you know, violin history, it's kind of young instrument compared to Stradivarius. They already like 350 years old. So this is much easier to maintain because the wood is young, still young. So,
but they withstand the test of time, which also goes well for the buildings too. Wood is a really great material.
Yeah. Great. So anyway, thanks so much, and to Dan and everyone here at Skyscraper Museum for being involved in
thanks
the
for that
production of this concert.
You can tell who the professor is.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.